What's up, Juice Nits? Back with another Flash Comic Review, and guys, we're actually getting to the final storyline of Joshua Williams' run. Guys, this is big, alright? Because his run has been almost 100 issues, and by its end, you'll get over 100 issues. So this is the final four-part, I think it's four-part, it's either three or four-part story arc titled Finish Line. And guys, what we've seen up to this point is we got Reverse Flash is taking over Barry's body here, right? He's taking over the Flash's body, Barry has been sucked into his mind, and at last issue ended with Barry seeing zombie versions of Max Mercury and Jesse Quick. Now, what's going on with Iris, Wally, and Avery? They're just at a house in Blue Valley, and they're just staying there so Reverse Flash won't attack them. Now, we also have the Legion of Zoom, which is Gorilla Grodd, Captain Cold, Golden Glider, Trickster, and the Turtle, and they're just attacking, right? Because they made a deal with Reverse Flash, and Reverse Flash gets what he wants, then these villains will know their future. They'll find out their future, and by doing this, if they know their future, they can correct it so they win, right? But going into this issue, we got a dope cover, guys. I actually really like this cover, because we see pretty much Reverse Flash, he's hacking stuff, and I was just like, Barry, what's wrong with you? But Reverse Flash, being Barry's body, is like, I'm fine. So it shows that there's going to be some conflict in this issue, a lot of conflict. But how this issue opens up is very nice in a way. You see Reverse Flash as Barry, alright? He's just running. Alright, he's running, you see him saving people in Central City, and he's like, this is all I ever wanted, to be the Flash, to be the fastest man alive, but to be adored by Central City, be a hero, and do what Barry could never do. He's like, I could always save people, but I would never screw up things. And I say, like, you know how Barry screwed up a lot of things, most importantly, time travel. But Reverse Flash is like, I won't screw up things, I can save Central City, and this is what Barry should have always been. Now, you see him travel to the Young Justice, and if you guys don't know the Young Justice, Reverse Flash is not traveling there to just say what's up, right? No, he's going there for Impulse, because Impulse is actually pretty much the grandson of Barry, but he became the Flash way back in Flash Comics, and I actually may cover that story on this channel eventually, because I actually really like that story. But Impulse, he came back in like Flash Annual number 2, I think it was issue number 2, and he came back, was gone for a little bit, they joined Young Justice, and he has been on this series, the Flash series, ever since. But he's here now for the final storyline, and you see Impulse just talking to the Young Justice, like, hey, you guys should check out my video games from the future, right? But they're just not talking. He's like, hey, why are you guys not talking? And that's when Reverse Flash shows up. Obviously, it's the Flash, right? And Impulse is like, oh, Grandpa, you're here. Because Flash tells him, like, hey, the Young Justice ain't listening to you because they're not on our level. You know, they're going so fast that they see people still, right? But you have them talking. Flash is like, hey, what's up? And Impulse is like, oh, you're my Grandpa. I'm sorry I haven't seen you. But you know how all time travel. You know about that stuff, right? And Flash is like, hey, we're inseparable. We're supposed to be with each other. Hey, let's go do some stuff. And Impulse is like, well, should I tell my friends? And Flash is like, no, don't worry about. They only notice you're gone. And that's when Impulse like, eat my dust. And they start racing. They run off. And what we see from here is we shift to inside the Flash's mind with Barry. And you see Barry still being attacked by these zombie Max Mercury and Jesse Quick. They're attacking him, right? And Barry's like, no, stop. And these zombies are actually saying, get a hold of yourself. Stop with all this guilt. Come on, take control. And that's when Barry actually finally, before phasing out, he's about to be phased out completely, starts taking control, right? And they're like, that's the spirit. And turns out these are actually not zombie versions. These are actually the real versions of Max Mercury and Jesse Quick. And it's like, hey, it's great to see you, Barry. And Barry's like, how? How could I? Why was I seeing you like zombies? And Jesse Quick is like, well, that's because you had so much guilt in what you do at Flashpoint, and you had guilt with us that you were seeing us as nightmares instead of friends. But we're here now. And Barry's like, oh, you're the Zen Speedster. You are Max Mercury. Oh, Jesse Quick. Oh, is your dad here? And she's like, no, my dad, Johnny Quick, died. He died way before Flashpoint, but I still feel him. And that's when Max Mercury asked Barry, like, hey, how'd you get to see us? How'd you come here? And Barry's like, I didn't. Eobard Thawne actually took control of my body. I'm stuck here. And Max Mercury's like, well, Eobard Thawne always wanted to be you, but I never thought he'd take it so literally, right? He's literally Flash. He's inside his body. And that's when Max Mercury's like, hey, do you know how to control, like, your mind? Because the Speed Force doesn't just go physically. Like, it's not just with a physical body. It's not just the mind. It's way deeper than that. He's like, do you know how to control that? And Barry's like, oh, is that like speed thinking? And Max Mercury's like, oh, that's catchy. Yeah, so just go into your mind, think about it. And that's when Barry starts to see through Reverse Flash's eyes, or his own eyes, pretty much Barry's own eyes through his body, and he sees that Reverse Flash is running with Impulse. And Barry's like, oh my gosh, he has Impulse. I forgot all about him. And that's when Max Burke is like, yeah, you forget about a lot of people. We gotta save him. We gotta teach you, Barry, how to take control of your body again. Because if he already has impulse, he's gonna do some bad stuff. We gotta save him. So that's when Max Burke is like, hey, come with me. Come with me and Jesse Quick, Barry. And we'll teach you all we know about the Speed Force as quick as possible. Now that's when we shift to see Captain Cold and Golden Glider Trickster. And they're just attacking like a bank, right? They're just robbing this bank. Golden Glider says, we might be from the past, but the security is still bad in the future. And we see all these different police, and they're like, wow, well, what the heck? I thought Flash beat the crap out of Captain Cold and Golden Glider, and they just skipped town. I thought Trickster is in Iron Heights. They're all confused, right? Imagine you're a police, or just a part of pretty much the police in Central City, and you're like, I thought we took down these villains. And they're just getting attacked, and you see Trickster, he just says to all of them, he's like, hey, isn't this fun? Instead of taking orders from Reverse Flash, we can actually just do some scams, do some certain things, and spend our time well. That's Reverse Flash shows up in Barry's body with Impulse, and he's like, Impulse, you think you can take him down? And Impulse is like, dude, Flash is run. He starts running after them, and Golden Glider's like, what is he doing here? And Captain Cold's like, get back, sis, we gotta take him down. And Golden Glider's like, but he's not actually the Flash, that's Reverse Flash. Captain Cold's like, just stay back, we can take care of this. And that's when Reverse Flash is like, snark, stop. Because he's saying to Captain Cold, like, yeah, we're on the same side, but you're going against my plan. But at the same time, Barry's trying to control. He's like, Bart, stop running, turn behind you. So Impulse is hearing all this stuff. Impulse is like, I am, I'm running. Like, stop talking. Impulse is getting kind of like irritated, right? Imagine hearing all these voices, and it's coming from Flash behind you, but it's actually voices from two different people. But you have, that's when Reverse Flash actually grabs his head. It's like, Barry. He knows that Barry's trying to take control, so Reverse Flash has to solve this problem. But Impulse, he's going around, you see Trickster, he shows up, and Trickster's like, oh, you're the Flash again. And that's when Reverse Flash is like, oh, am I? And that's when he throws like a bomb at Trickster, takes him out, and he holds him in his hands like James Jesse. He's always trying to fool everyone when he's actually the real fool. And that's when Impulse is like, oh, what should we do with him? And Reverse Flash is like, let's just leave him here. Impulse is like, we should take him to a hospital. Like, we should actually save him. And that's when Reverse Flash is like, really? That's not justice? You want to save a rogue? He's like, maybe you're not Flash family material. You're supposed to save citizens, not rogues. And he's like, I put too much on you, Bart. And he's like, now you're back to Impulse. You were Kid Flash before. God forbid you come to Flash again. You know that didn't turn out well. You see Impulse just being broken down because Reverse Flash is just like scolding him about all this over Impulse wanting to save Trickster. Like, come on. And Reverse Flash is like, hey, just go back to your friends. Go away for a couple years. I'll handle all the Flash business. And Impulse is like, what the heck? What did I do? It just stands there like confused, right? And that's when we shift to Gorilla Grodd back at the base, right? With the leeches zoom, he's like, hey, we gotta know what Reverse Flash is doing because he took Barry's body, but he's not really helping us. And Charles like, yeah, I agree. What's he actually doing? And that's when the Tornado Twins is like, hey, trust Uncle Earbard. He has everything under control. Just listen to him. And that's when Captain Cold and Golden Glider show up and like, hey, we need to pretty much team up and take down Reverse Flash. We don't know what's happening. He actually may be actually the Flash and taking over and actually maybe going against us. But that's when Reverse Flash comes in with the Trickster, throws him on the ground. It's like, I told you guys to stay here. And Gorilla Grodd's like, you can't just be commanding orders at us. Like, you need to tell us what actually benefits we get from you taking over the Flash's body. And that's when Reverse Flash says that Barry is slowly taking control back of him and he needs to get these certain items so he can have full control. So he tells the Legion of Zoom, go get these items and I'll be in full control of this body and then I'll show you guys your future. And Gorilla Grodd is like, really? You can't show us now? And he sees the Trickster and he just smiles. Now we shift to Blue Valley where Iris, Avery, and Wally are. And Wally is saying, hey, like, we should do something. I don't like just sitting around here. And Avery's like, hey, Barry told us to protect Iris. That's why we actually got located in this place in Blue Valley that Barry doesn't even know about, that Reverse Flash doesn't know about. And Wally's like, yeah, I get that. And he was like, hey, we gotta do a good job. And that's when Flash shows up, Reverse Flash controlling the body. He's like, oh, you guys do a great job. I'm proud of you, Avery. I'm proud of you, Wally. And they're like, wait, are we supposed to see each other? We're not supposed to see each other for a few days. And I was like, how'd you find us? And Reverse Flash is like, well, you're my lightning rod. I found this part kind of funny, honestly, because Reverse Flash is trying to find a way to get past this and in a way, like, lied to them, but he's struggling to figure that out. But he got away with just saying, "You're my lightning rod." And they come to him and they're like, "Wait, did you take down Reverse Flash?" He's like, Yeah, I already took down the Abarth. I'm like, "Wait, what about the Legion of Zoom?" He's like, "Hey, enough with all these questions. What about you? What about all of us? Just team up. I know where Eobard's like little team is heading. We can take him down and have a great time." That's when Impulse comes out of nowhere, kicks Flash in the face, or kicks Reverse Flash in the face, big hit, and he's like, "You're not the Flash." Barry might be quiet, distant, awkward, but he's never mean. Here's a Flash fact: you're not my grandpa. And he kicks Reverse Flash into the sky, into some trees. So Impulse just shows up and he's like, "You're not my grandpa." And then he comes to Wally. Wally's like, "Who the heck are you?" And Impulse's like, "Who the heck are you?" And then we have Avery's like, "What's going on?" And then Impulse like, "Well, I'm Impulse, not Kid Flash. You're Kid Flash, right?" And Wally's like, "Yeah, I'm Kid Flash." And Avery's like, "Oh, that name Impulse makes sense on what just happened." And you see Reverse Flash, he's like, "Man, I should have killed that little brat." And you have Iris, she comes out, and Avery's like, "Who, you're not family. You're not pretty much connected to us." And Iris is like, "Yes, he is family. I know him." And that's when Bart goes up to Iris. He's like, "I'm sorry. I've been hanging out with the Young Justice crew. I've been distracted. I couldn't see you. Do you actually still remember me?" And Iris is like, "Yes, I'll always remember you." And that hair, she's like, "Bart, come here." And they hug. You see Iris and Bart, they have a great hug. And then Bart's like, "Where's Wally?" And that's when Iris is like, "You don't know?" And in their mind still, Wally's dead. But as we know, Wally, he's like, has Dr. Manhattan powers. He's in the whole Death Metal event. So if you want to see where Wally is, check out my Death Metal videos right here. But if you don't care about that, then just know in this storyline that they think he's dead still. Because he technically died, in Heroes in Crisis. And Iris, Flash, they all don't know that he's still alive. Barry does know that he's alive in Death Metal, but not Iris. But we see here, and you see Reverse Flash is running. He's like, "Well, Wally was the one that thought of the whole Flash family thing. But Barry, maybe he's been doing all the wrong. Maybe the best Flash is the one that runs alone." And he comes up to them, and Iris is like, "Oh, I know you did. You're not Barry. You took over his body." And Reverse Flash is like, "Oh, you're trying to question me?" He's like, "I know your future. I know how to kill you all. And I'm actually, my MO is killing people before it's their time." Reverse Flash goes up to him, he's gonna kill Avery, Kid Flash, Impulse, and Iris. But somebody from the distance is like, "Hey, with all due respect, stay the hell away from these kids." And you see Jake Garrick right in front of them. This guy, oh my gosh, this part is amazing, guys. I got so hyped. You see Jake Garrick right in front of them, and Reverse Flash is shocked. He just got beat up by Impulse, and now you got Jake Garrick to deal with? Like, come on. Ever since that story in Flash number 750 of Jake Garrick, I love that story. That's probably the best story in the entire issue. There's maybe another one that was pretty good too, but I really like that one. And seeing Jake Garrick join this storyline, we got Impulse and Jake Garrick in one issue. Like, come on. This is one of the best issues of the series to date, just because of that fact. The seeing Jay Garrick show up, I was so shocked. Because I knew that he was going to show up in the storyline, but I didn't know he'd show up so quickly in like the first part. And yeah, guys, I said we got Impulse and Jay Garrick, but we also have Max Mercury, Jesse Quick, so many Flash family members in this storyline, and obviously Flash's best villain, Reverse Flash, and other great villains like Captain Gold, Golden Glider, and Gorilla Grodd, and the Turtle, and Trickster. This is a great time to be a Flash fan. You should be definitely checking out this book. And guys, that's actually where the issue ends. We'll see how this turns out next issue with all these characters in play. We'll see if Reverse Flash actually carries out his plan and how Joshua Williams will wrap up this whole run that's been over 100 issues and a couple issues, right? I think we got two or three more parts and then we'll see the ending. But guys, overall, I'm going to give this issue of The Flash a 9.7 out of 10. I just loved it, guys. The art by Hoffa Sandoval and Scott Collins was just amazing. It was just done so well, and all the characters returning, it just gave me so nostalgic vibes, you know? And just all the different, the pacing was well done, the writing was good, all the action was cool, and I just enjoyed reading this. Like, yeah, it felt like a fast read, but that's because it's such a good read. Like, sometimes people think, okay, it's a fast read, that means there's not a lot of content, right? But no, there's a lot of content here. But such good content that just goes by faster to read. But yeah, guys, if you like the video, give a big thumbs up on each channel. Make sure to subscribe to my next Flash comic review. I'll be definitely reviewing this, the rest of this storyline, and then reviewing the Flash series afterwards. But guys, in the comment section below, tell me that about this issue. Did you love it? Did you hate it? What do you think about the return of Max Mercury, Jesse Quick, Jay Garrick, Impulse? What do you think about Reverse Flash taking over Barry's body? And what was your favorite moment from this issue? And guys, which artist do you think is better, Hoffa Sandoval or Scott Collins? In my opinion, I like Hoffa Sandoval's art better, because it's just more clean. But Scott Collins, I read a lot of Flash stories with his art in it, so it gives me like a nostalgic feel, so that's really good too. But yeah, guys, thanks for watching, and peace out.